众大家好，欢迎收看我们英文翻译第15次播出，我是蒋小珍。我们今天要谈的题目是英汉文化的对比与翻译，第一部分哈，其实是蛮有趣的。首先介绍跟我一块主持节目的老师。
Yes, 我是魏查德。And welcome everybody, and let's get on with it.
好，我们来开始哈，今天的这个 Principles of Translation 翻译原理。我们知道在这英汉的文化这个其实要对比起来范围很广哈。那么所谓文化，什么叫文化呢？其实包括一个民族它所特有的思维的方式 ideas， 还民间习俗啊 customs。以及它的艺术文化文物，比如 art。那么中西文化，这个差异呈现在很多方面。我们常想的，譬如在饮食哈、起居都是不一样啦。日常生活、风俗、喜庆甚至文学、哲学医学、政治、宗教等方面都是不同。那我们这次这一章跟下次一章，我们要用5个方式来讨论中西文化差异。我们讨论到中西的饮食，还有婚礼、喜宴。这个著名的经典啊，还有文化意象，也中西成语等5个方面谈，做一些比较略加的这个讨论，其实也没办法很深入的谈哈，因为呢太广泛了，只做一些例子而已。那基本上告诉你说，在中西文化差异这么大的时候，要做很好的翻译是有些困难的哈。首先谈到中西饮食方面，我们中国传统美食哈是扬名国际，我们都知道，中国菜非常讲究，变化多端啦，真的让西方人是自叹不如。中国菜的烹饪方式哈，佳肴美味，还有这个药膳进补和西方饮食，真的这个差异蛮显著的。我们炒菜的时候说要注重火候，对不对？你会不会讲大火快炒？就大概是 high heat 很高热的，或者很慢火，那 low heat 来炖啊煮啊哈，这些方式都关乎菜的色跟它的味道。我想先做简单的表列试试看，就是中西他们烹调的烹饪的方式的有不同哈。我跟 Charles 老师一起跟大家介绍看看，还有哪些中国人做菜的方式。炒怎么说
？Stir fry。
还有我们这个比如炸。
Deep fry。
嗯哼。炖呢
？Stew。
好，还有过油怎么说
？Quickly fry at once。
好，再来我们看一下有焖哈。
Steam with the heat off。
好，还有熬。
Another word for stew。
Stew 也可以哈。
Maybe a different kind of stew。嗯
哼。那熬也是 stew 哈，煎。
Saute。
啊哈，还有看一下煲哈，这种煲怎么说
？Pot。
还有煨哈。
Another one, another kind of stewing.
Stew 哈哈。还有这个涮，我们涮羊肉的涮哈。
Dip。
还有熏。
Smoke。
焗。
Bake in low heat。
烩。
Cover with sauce。
那这个西方他们怎么有哪些方式呢
？Fry。
煎呢？哈，油煎炸哈，或者这个炒都叫 fry。再来。
Bake。
烤炉、烤箱哈，放在加热的这个。这个铁板上面烧烤都叫 bake， 再来
，roast，
那烤箱来焖烧，那烧哈烤
，grill，
直接用火在这个铁网上面或者成串的这个来烧烤
，boil，
在水中煮，外国人像青菜的水里面煮哈，好，这是一个基本上我们要用不同的方法来说。其实中国像炖啦、熬啦、煨啦，英国实在英文没有什么确切的字对应，老师刚刚说都叫 stew 就好了哈。好，中西饮食除了烹调和技巧方面不同以外，很多传统美食我们从来自动物的内脏，譬如说 innards 或 entrails 哈，猪啊、牛啊，他们的这个肝呐、
liver，
啊胃呢
，stomach，
还有这个肾
，kidney，
鸡啊、鸭这个头啊。爪凤爪什么还有针哈
gizzard
这些都内脏哈西方有的人觉得就比较不是很干净他们都不大吃哈那近年来西方在这个倡导所谓的环保哈所以很多人士说不能再吃这些动物的这些东西了然后要保 保护一些这个，比如说是一些稀有动物哈，所以他们主张像我们喜欢吃的东西都觉得不应该再大肆的提倡，像我们喜欢吃什么鱼翅啦，对不对哈？还鱼翅怎么说
？Sharks fins。
还有燕窝。
Bird's nest。
啊哈，还有这个熊掌哈。
Bear's paw。
熊胆。
Bear's gall。
这都是所谓的真肴哈，那我们其实还蛮讲究进补的，所以在翻译的时候，你要讲这些补品啊、补药啊，这膳这药材、膳材等等，都很难讲。有当归、枸杞啊，冬虫夏草，要找英文的字翻实在不容易哈。老师，当归有没有比较适合的说法
？Chireta。
如果说冬虫夏草。
Winter bug, summer grass.
照字面翻。
No.
其实这很难呢、啊。我们其实就简单说怎么办
？No, you just have a kind of Chinese herb.
好，他说 kind of Chinese herb. The H-E-R-B, H 不要发音 ，herb 就好了哈。Okay, Charles, do you eat animal innards?
Well, yes. Sometimes I eat liver, especially chicken liver, to raise the iron count in my blood.Yeah, I do that sometimes.
老是吃点那个鸡的那个liver 肝哈，要提升他血中的这个身体的 iron 铁质了哈。好，我们第二个想讲的是婚礼喜庆哈，喜宴。那么中西有不同的这个喜庆的场合，有不同的风俗。中西婚礼这个宴会当中哈，也蛮有趣的对照。其实像我们中国哈，很多的婚礼的习俗哈，这种 practices 大概是外国人所没有的。举例说明，婚前要合八字 ，how to say that?
The dates of birth for both the bride and the bridegroom must be matched.
好，那个 date 要 match 的。那我们结婚的时候，譬如要找房子要看风水，怎么说啊？
It's called the feng shui of a new house.
没有办法翻，就是风水。
Yeah, we don't have an equivalent of that in English.
没有 equivalent 啊。那我们买家具啦、安床啦，要看这生辰八字啊，要择良辰这个吉日，对不对？还看新居风水，这都西方没有的哈。所以呢，这个再加上这个，那合八字哈，真的是只有把意思讲出来，没有很确切的字。我们刚刚看过哈，那 the dates of birth, the birth for the bride and Bridegroom must be matched. 这是把意思讲出来。风水那就声音来翻风水哈。好，那么看西洋他们结婚的时候，在譬如女孩子要结婚以前，她的好朋友帮她举行一些小型的宴会给她一些有助于她将来料理家务的东西，譬如毛巾啊、床单啊、厨房用品啊、银器等等。那这个我们俗称英文叫什么
？Bridal shower。
好，这 bridal shower 哈，其实，在我们中国的这个言辞当中，没有 equivalent， 没不知道怎么说它哈，那就简单说，可能是这个新娘的婚前一个贺礼的一个 party 了，类似这样子。那 Charles， a bride in your country usually wears a white wedding gown.、
Yes.
What else should she wear?
Well, there's an old superstition, maybe you call it, that she'll make a good beginning on her marriage if she wears something old, something new, something borrowed, and something blue.
Yeah, so we look at the picture, it has something blue, a red one. You want the bride wearing, and also, besides the white dress, something old, a little old, something new, something new, something borrowed, to bring with you, borrowed things to wear. Ha, and something blue, a little red. Ha, this is very interesting. Ha, so Western, this wedding, this ended after the bride, ha.他要拿一个花往后面丢，对不对？那花怎么说
？Bridal bouquet.
Bouquet 哈 ，bride bouquet 往后面丢。那后面的这个没有结婚女孩捡到就幸运儿，下一个 next 她就要结婚了哈。那其实这些婚礼这些习俗在我们两个文化当中不同，很难有很好的一个解释。我又想到说，在我们中国哈，譬如女孩子要结婚，对不对？那就是说这个。在接到夫家去的时候，新娘父亲大概都会泼个水，对不对？泼水里 ，spill water 哈、那就嫁出去，女儿像泼出去的水哈。英文怎么解释呢
？This symbolizes the finality of the daughter's departure. You can't pick up spilled water.
女儿嫁出去了，泼出去的水哈。好，我们先看这，来，我们先休息一下。 我们除了这个中西的饮食烹饪还有这个风俗习惯婚礼啊，还是经典名著也不同。其实文化要素之一是思想，一个民族的思想，那么深受它的传统的这个经典的影响哈。那我们中华文化一直最重要的影响力来自，譬如说孔孟啦，这个四书五经啦，诗词歌赋、唐诗宋词、明清小说、五四散文等等，都影响我们。所以，我们讲话常常会这个从这么大一个庞大的丰富的文化遗产中去引用。同样的，在西方语系当中哈，那他们的人民的思想方式跟表达内容也深受一些非常重要的作品，譬如圣经啦、莎士比亚、希腊罗马神话等这种经典名著的影响。那要了解两种文化的不同，那对这些重要的这种作品文化资产要有涉猎哈，那否则在翻译的时候会碰到一些典故，你可能觉得说会译错或者不知道怎么翻。中文的文学当然是我们典故不胜枚举啦，因为时间不是很多，想我们就讨论英文的一些典故哈。有些典故你应该要知道哈，像圣经都是最重要的，我们举例说明看看一些用法。
Don't waste your time and breath. It's not worth casting pearls before swine.
好，就是直译是说，不要浪费你的时间和力气了，根本不值得在猪罗面前撒珍珠。这来自圣经里面的，那就所以就是说，好像是在这个外邦人面前讲神的道理哈。那基本上是马太福音里面的，也就是我们中文所谓的好像是这个不要对牛弹琴哈，这个意思来源是圣经哈。我们看另一个句子
，Change the widow's mite to the widow's mite。
好，这是来自圣经，他说，把这寡妇的小钱变成寡妇的力量 ，mite 跟 might 一样念法，这是从这个新约马克福音里面来的哈，就指寡妇把自己的所有的钱都献给耶稣，得到了赞美。那其实这是一个寿险的公司广告啊，说女孩子你要保险的保小钱，将来做寡妇的时候一大笔赔理赔哈。那意思说低捐成巨流，小钱变大钱，来源是出自圣经的哈。除了圣经之外，西方很重要的来源是它的希腊罗马神话哈。譬如说我们举个你常常听到 Achilles heel 哈，什么叫 Achilles heel 呢？意思就是说一个叫阿基里斯，他的脚更是他的致命伤哈。所以我们后来就指一般人的缺点哈，我们有些英文说法看看。
Achilles heel, someone's weak spot or point. All of us have our own Achilles heel.
我们都有大家的缺点哈，弱点。那还有什么说法呢
？Her damaged eyes have been her Achilles heel.
她受伤的双眼是她的弱点，这意思哈。那在神话当中有一个叫做Midas Touch。那 Midas 是神话中很有钱的一个人哈，我们怎么说？
Great money-making ability.
今天这么说哈，就指有本事赚钱，有本事理财哈。我们做个句子。
The Wang family seemed blessed with a Midas touch for more than 50 years.
好，王氏家族五十多年来得天之赐，身材有道，财源滚滚，这个意思哈。那么还有，我们看莎士比亚是大家所耳熟能详一些话啊。那这些常常被用来，特别在这个报章、杂志或新闻的时候常常用到。你也许知道啊，这个 Hamlet， 哈姆雷特，《王子复仇记》有一句话说，这个 "To be or not to be, that is the question"， 就生或是死是个大问题。这个常常被新闻拿来用哈。那这个结构就是说，"to be" 哈，就是说，不定词加 or 再加否定不定词 "not to be"。那这个报纸张这个新闻标题蛮多的，我们可以看一看哈。
For OPEC, to be or not to be.
OK, 那油国组织哈是存乎或者废乎，用这个句型了。还有呢
？To meet or not to meet.
谈判或者不谈判。
Israel's leaders feud over peace talks.
意思是以色列领导阶层和平起了争端哈。那再看另一个结构。
To build or not to build.
建乎还是拆乎呢？
That is the question that riles London's preservationists.
拆建问题，这个惹火了伦敦古迹维护人士。 好，英语典故除了来自刚刚讲的圣经啊、希腊罗马神话、莎士比亚以外，还有一些童话故事、文学作品也是重要来源。我们举例看看，你很能熟悉一个叫做《爱丽丝梦游仙境》，对不对 ？Alice in Wonderland， 那什么意思呢？就表示意味着梦幻啊，不切实际哈。还有我们常听到的灰姑娘 Cinderella， 那今天表示穷困女仆啦，摇身一变变成这个好像是闪烁的王妃，或者乌鸦、麻雀、变凤凰，都来自这里。那文学名著也常用来表示特殊意义。如果你还记得英国一个叫做Jonathan Swift 哈，他写个这个大小人国，对不对？《格列佛游记》（Gulliver's Travels） 里面大人国叫做Brobdingnag， 就表示巨大的意思；小人国叫Lilliput， 就表示很微小的意思。这些词都有名到说变一般的形容词了哈。那更有一个叫做英国的 Thomas More 哈，那他写一个《Utopia》乌托邦这本书，今天这个字也变成我们的形容词。当你 Utopia 大写表示理想国 ，Utopia 小写表示是一个理想、梦幻的、梦想的、不切实际哈。所以这些就告诉我们，再三表示这个在这么庞大的英国的这个传统里面，你要花点心思去了解。好，我们看看今天我们的famous quotations 部分。
No bees, no honey, no work, no money.
无风则无米，无劳则无获。
Make haste slowly.
急事缓办。
Time will tell.
时间会证明一切。
Walls have ears.
隔墙有耳。
All that glitters is not gold.
金玉其外，败絮其中。来看我们今天dialogue 部分哈，我们今天要谈呢 meal。好，先看我们的 vocabulary and expressions。
Short time no see。
有段时间不见。
Supper。
晚餐。
Limp。
跛脚。
Lunar New Year。
旧历年。
Hinder。
阻碍。
Recover,
复原
cause,
造成
purine,
普林
protein,
蛋白质
ache,
疼痛
extremity,
躯干
subside,
缓和
metabolism,
新陈代谢
drain off,
排出
excess,
过多的
uric acid,
尿酸
Equation.
均衡
Boil down to.
追根究底
Respond.
反应
Analogy.
类比
Parallel.
相似
In the opposite way.
相反的
Electric train.
电动火车，这边指玩具哈
Paratrooper.
伞兵
Anything but.
除了什么之外的任何事情
Do one's level best.
尽全力
Prevent.
预防防止
Skydiver.
跳伞运动选手
License.
许可证或执照
Airborne division.
空降小组
Frozen.
吓呆了，冻了
Proverbial.
谚语的
Icy plunge.
冰冷跳降
Confront.
面临
anxious
焦虑的
task
任务
finish
结束
turn in
交出
journal
期刊
abstract
摘要好我们今天先休息一下来我们先看我们这个这一段 dialogue 的英文部分
Short time no see. When did you get in?
Only a few minutes ago.
Same here. So we're both right on time for supper.
True enough. Luckily, the bus wasn't delayed an extra half hour.
Still limping on one foot, I see. Did spending the Lunar New Year up north help or hinder your recovery?
Apparently, made the foot a little worse. If only for a short time. Not certain what caused it. I'm still drinking as much water as possible, avoiding beans or anything made therefrom, meat and fish, nuts, whatever is high in purine, which is what most high-protein foods tend to be, such that this aching in the extremities can subside as the metabolism drains off excess uric acid.
What the whole equation boils down to is how individual metabolism responds. The best analogy, parallel or whatever, can be found in the human mind.
Every bit of which is heavily dependent on the person's reaction, which can show up in opposite ways.
That's true too. Witness how some fathers used to give their sons electric trains for Christmas or birthdays, while others gave anything but those items.
And recall that story we watched a long time ago, that ex-paratrooper who did his level best to prevent the skydivers from attaining a license for their training school.
In that, he himself had briefly served in the airborne division and frozen when looking down from a plane on his first jump.
A proverbial icy plunge, literally in his case. Lucky us. We've never confronted any such thing, yet.
Not quite. Still, we've both experienced some anxious moments of late, haven't we? This is my first such task in a long time, since my MA thesis.
Same with me, almost. You finished editing the day before yesterday, so you wrote.
Yes, vacation or no vacation, I couldn't truly rest until that was off my mind. No longer hanging over me. I'll turn it in as fast as the departmental office opens.
That makes us two of a kind. One matched pair. Part of my winter break was spent that way also.
Now if the journals will come through and print them, one said the main body of mine had to be all in Chinese, whereas another wanted only the abstract translated.
好，我想问老师一些问题啊。Charles, what foods are high in purine?
Beans, meat, fish, nuts, we can say most high protein foods are. Mm. They can cause excess uric acid and, mm-hmm. and in the blood and that, in the extremities that leads to mm-hmm. what we call gout. You call mm-hmm. it tong feng.
Gout, tong feng. Yes. Mm. 尿酸过多.
Yeah, and mm-hmm. you can...I mean, maybe the joints here turn yellow like a raincoat. Mm-hmm. So then you know you got excess uric acid in yours, and you'll feel it in your extremities. See. Mm-hmm.
Okay, 好，那我们现在看这一段绘画它的中文部分。
Short time no see. When did you get in?
Only a few minutes ago.
Same here. So we're both right on time for supper.
True enough. Luckily, the bus wasn't delayed an extra half hour.
Still limping on one foot, I see. Did spending the Lunar New Year up north help or hinder recovery?
Apparently, made the foot a little worse, if only for a short time. Not certain what caused it. I'm still drinking as much water as possible, avoiding beans or anything made therefrom, meat and fish, nuts, whatever is high in purine, which is what most high-protein foods tend to be.Such that this aching in the extremities can subside as the metabolism drains off excess uric acid.
What the whole equation boils down to is how individual metabolism responds. The best analogy, parallel or whatever, can be found in the human mind.
Every bit of which is heavily dependent on the person's reaction, which can show up in opposite ways.
That's true too.Witness how some fathers used to give their sons electric trains for Christmas or birthdays, while others gave anything but those items.
And recall that story we watched a long time ago, that ex-paratrooper who did his level best to prevent the skydivers from attaining a license for their training school.
In that, he himself had briefly served in the airborne division and frozen when looking down from a plane on his first jump.
A proverbial icy plunge, literally in his case. Lucky us.We've never confronted any such thing, yet.
Not quite. Still, we've both experienced some anxious moments of late, haven't we? This is my first such task in a long time, since my MA thesis.
Same with me, almost. You finished editing the day before yesterday, so you wrote.
Yes, vacation or no vacation, I couldn't truly rest until that was off my mind, no longer hanging over me.I'll turn it in as fast as the departmental office opens.
That makes us two of a kind. One matched pair. Part of my winter break was spent that way also.
Now if the journals will come through and print them, one said the main body of mine had to be all in Chinese, whereas another wanted only the abstract translated.
好，我们来做我们这个句型翻译的练习。Let's practice.
The bus wasn't delayed an extra half hour.
公车没有再迟到半小时。我们要学一个 be delayed 迟到哈，来做做看。因为大雨，飞机起飞延后了半小时。提示一下，飞机起飞怎么说
？Take off.
大雨呢
？Downpour.
好，做做看。
The takeoff was delayed half an hour because of the downpour. The takeoff was delayed half an hour because of the downpour.
哪一个错了
？First one, you need to say an instead of a.
Hour 母音 an 哈。另外做做看。
The downpour delayed takeoff half an hour.
很好，我们看下一句。因机械故障，这班火车慢了45分钟哈。提示一下，这个机械故障怎么说
？Mechanical problems.
好，来试试看。
The train was delayed 45 minutes due to mechanical problems. This train was delayed 45 minutes due to machine problems.
哪一个错了？
They both get the same meaning, but the first one is our way of saying it. It's our accepted way of saying it. So the second would be grammatically right, but we just don't say it that way.
文法是对，可是他们不这么说。机械故障就是 mechanical， 不是 machine 哈。好，来我们另外翻看看。
This train was held up 45 minutes by mechanical problems.
很好，我们看第二个例句。
Did spending the Lunar New Year up north help or hinder your recovery?
在北部过农历年对你的复原是有利还是有弊呢？我们要学哈 ，hinder from 就是阻碍或者妨碍，脚扭到让我不能够四处走动哈。我们的脚扭到怎么说
？Sprained ankle。
好，试试看。
Spraining ankle hinders me from walking around.Sprained ankle hinders me from walking around.
哪一个错
？The first one we're supposed to say sprained.
脚是被扭到。
Spraining、
过去分词比较好哈。Sprained.
If you said spraining an ankle, maybe that would be right.
也可以哈。那我们看另外做做看。
A sprained ankle hampers my walk.
好 ，hamper 跟 hinder 一样意思。下一句，我不但不会妨碍你，还会帮助你达成目标。达成目标怎么说？
Achieve the goal.
好，试试看。
I will help rather than hinder you to achieve your goal. I will help rather than hinder you from achieving your goal.
哪一个错了？
The first one.
我们刚说应该 hinder 是用 from 哈，不是用 to， 对不对？好，另外做做看。
I will help and not hinder you from attaining your goal.
好 ，attain, achieve 都是一样，达到你的目标。好，看个例句。
I'm still drinking as much water as possible, avoiding beans or anything made therefrom.
我还是尽量多喝水，而且尽量少吃豆制品。我们来学 as much as possible， 尽量的意思哈。来做一句。我尽量不去想这件事，但人不时出现在我心中。我们提示一下，出现在我心中是
hang over me，
不时
once in a while。
好，做做看。
I have tried not to think about it as much as possible, but it still hangs over me once in a while. I have tried not to think about it as most as possible, but it still hangs over me once in a while.
好，哪一个错？
And the second one's like Chinglish.
要讲 as much 不是 as most。好，我们先坐这里。那么下个礼拜继续再来看我们的节目，要好好用功哦。拜拜。
See you.